Differential diagnosis of Graves disease or primary toxic goitre. First of all, differential diagnosis of polyphagia with loss of weight. The commonest causes are thyrotoxicosis, diabetes mellitus, parasitic diseases, and malabsorption syndrome. Also, there is important differential diagnosis between the CNS symptoms of primary toxic goitre and anxiety neurosis. And actually, differential diagnosis between the two needs investigations. There is also important differential diagnosis is differential diagnosis of other causes of thyrotoxicosis. The most important is differential diagnosis between primary thyrotoxicosis and the secondary thyrotoxicosis. First of all, the incidence. The primary thyrotoxicosis usually occurs in young age, below 40 years. While secondary toxic goitre is toxicity occur on top of simple nodular goitre. We mentioned in simple nodular goitre that the commonest age is 30 to 40. And the patient live later on many years by simple nodular goitre. Then thyrotoxicosis occur on top of this simple nodular goitre. Therefore, it is logic that secondary thyrotoxicosis occur in older age, usually above 40. It is common in 50 years or 60 years. Onset of the primary toxic goitre. The onset of the primary toxic goitre as any autoimmune disease. The autoimmune disease usually occur rapidly. Here, there is rapid onset of manifestations of thyrotoxicosis without any previous history of neck swelling. Therefore, there is history of manifestation of thyrotoxicosis in normal gland without any previous history of any neck swelling or previous goitre. In secondary thyrotoxicosis, this is totally different. There is a previous history for many years by neck swelling, which is simple nodular goitre. And the manifestations of thyrotoxicosis develops with this simple nodular goitre after many years, insidiously. Insidious means very gradual. The course of the disease. The course of the disease as any severe autoimmunity. All autoimmune disease characterized by remissions and exacerbations. Weeks of severe suffering in this patient, followed by weeks or months by relief. Therefore, there is remissions and exacerbations. For Arabic student, العيانين بتوع أي autoimmune disease يا جماعة بيتعبوا قوي 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 فترة أسبوع أسبوعين ثلاثة, followed by relief and symptoms تقل جدا والعيان يتحسن قوي قوي, followed by increase symptoms and exacerbation again, etc. Therefore, remission and exacerbation is actually a feature of all autoimmune disease. In secondary thyrotoxicosis, there is no remission. Usually, the course is continuously progressive. The severity of symptoms and severity of manifestations according to the severity of immunity. The thyroid stimulating antibody titer is very high and autoimmunity is very severe in primary toxic goitre, leading to severe manifestations. While in secondary toxic goitre, usually it may be due to autoimmunity, but mild, moderate, minimal autoimmunity in secondary toxic goitre. Therefore, the severity of symptoms and manifestations are mild or moderate due to mild, moderate autoimmunity. The main manifestations of the disease: metabolic manifestation and CNS manifestations are the main symptoms and the main presentations and the more marked in primary toxic goitre. Therefore, in MCQ, if there is MCQ about the main manifestation of primary toxic goitre or Graves' disease, you should choose usually polyphagia with loss of weight or insomnia as a CNS manifestation. The reverse in secondary toxic goitre. In second toxic goitre, the patient is old, 50s, 60s years. The heart cannot withstand this tachycardia, this increased cardiac output, this hyperdynamic circulation, and heart failure may occur. Therefore, usually in secondary toxic goitre, the main manifestation is cardiovascular. Therefore, if there is MCQ, what is the main manifestation of secondary toxic goitre? As a symptom, usually palpitation. And as a sign is tachycardia. Therefore, take care in MCQ. The main manifestation of primary toxic goitre is either metabolic or CNS symptoms. While the main manifestation and the main symptom in secondary toxic goitre is cardiovascular symptom. Eye manifestations. There is severe eye manifestation, and all eye signs are present with true exophthalmos in primary toxic goitre. While in secondary toxic goitre, the eye manifestation minimal and related to aberrant exophthalmos. That is to say, aberrant exophthalmos, upper eyelid retraction, del Rimbel sign, and steering lock. If there is exophthalmos in secondary, it is always aberrant exophthalmos. Finally, what is the difference between the thyroid swelling? Sure, in secondary toxic goitre, there is manifestation of simple nodular goitre, irregular nodular firm goitre. While in Graves' disease, which is called diffuse toxic goitre, there is diffuse isthmus goitre. Finally, severity of autoimmunity, very severe, with high thyroid antibody titer in the circulation. And in secondary toxic goitre, there is mild or moderate thyroid antibody titer in the circulation. This is a differential diagnosis of thyrotoxicosis. Thank you for good listening.